to all my loved ones in Ghana. Could you send me, please, one of your colourful T-shirts, new blue colour? I'd be the happiest being ever existing. Thanks for a marvellous show, sincerely, from McCobbison. Well, this was fairly precise, wasn't it, Big Al? I don't know if we... Do we have them in blue?
Yeah, we've got a new range. That's what I'd like to know.
You're joking.
We've got a new range now.
A new range of BBC T-shirts?
Yes, it used to be just white ones, which were a bit messy, actually, because right. Every time you spilt something down the front, you can never get them out. And then you've got a grey, which are a bit...
Grey.
Yeah, a bit grey. And yeah. now we've got nice blue ones.
Wow. Well, McCopperson's going to be well pleased, then. He's going to get a blue one and Boys to Men with Motown Philly.
Yo, fellas, y'all ready to do this?
Yeah, yeah, what's up now?
Yo, these boys in Jackson is real smooth on the hobby, too. Nick, Mike, Sean, one, you know the mentality.
Keep sweating, yeah. The spotlight is on us now. Watch us do this.
Da-da, da-da,
live and direct from the Philly town.
Rapping, hyping, we can get down.
We are ready to go, so now the world will know that we flow.
Back in school, we used to dream about this every day. Could it really happen?
Or do dreams that fade away? Everybody's singing the bass and it's so smooth.
So we started a groove and here we are. Kicking it just for you.
Oh, 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 oh. I'm gonna be back again. Doing a little East Coast way. Point the men, going on.
Go, go.
Not too hard, not too soft.
Now check this out, one day back in Philly, four guys wanted to sing. They came up to me, I said, well, what's your name? Hey, you know what I'm saying? And then I said, all right, fellas, well, let me see what you can do. And then a smile on that one, they said, yo, Mike, check this out, see if this one moves you.
Well, it seems that all you need to get through the world now is to be able to say, yo, check this out, and people will understand what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Okay, Nick Bond from Wellington, New Zealand says, DLT, hello from below. Hang on, there's nothing under our table here.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
Just a rather mucky carpet. This is Wellington calling. No, not the boot, the harbour capital. I've been listening to you for over 30 years. Must be potty or deaf or something. Getting the beeb here is unreliable, but at the moment you arrive in our house each Sunday morning. How about playing something delectable for me? My standard of dress here leaves a lot to be desired, and the medium T-shirt would look great being besported on Lambton Quay in town, and I'll send you a Kiwi T-shirt in return. Double, double, extra large, I presume. You presume fairly correctly, actually, Nick. Yes, I do. I'd like... I mean, I'm a big fella. I'm not fat or anything, am I? I'm not... I've got a bit of weight on me, but I'm not fat, am I, Big Al? Seriously, fat. Oh, thanks a lot. Some producer, I need him. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cuddly.
Cuddly, yeah, okay, yeah. But I like big shirts because, you know, it gives me a bit of room to breathe in them. So, fine. It says here, thanks, and don't let Big Al crimp your zaniness. He won't get anywhere near me with those cramps, Nick, I promise you. Okay, what about Texas? What about Texas? No, the group, dear. Here it is. This is Say What You Want. Excellent group, Texas, and Say What You Want. It is now time to press the button that goes only slightly better than that. And it means, of course, it's time for Off the Wall. It's time for me to play something that I've brought in, something perhaps that hasn't been requested, and I think, oh, well, somebody should have requested it, so I'm requesting it instead. We've got a great piece of music coming up for you now. And here are the names of the people who are included this week in the dedications. Andrew Longoli from Jinja in Uganda says, please send my greetings to my dad and mum in Moroto, Tom in Gulu, and fellow students of Kira College. George Foya from Harare in Zimbabwe would like to pass on tender regards, he said, to the following people. Moffat Firi, Silas, Kane, Benjamin, and Bornface Matimba. And Philip Wiseman Jere from Mzimba in Malawi wants to send warm greetings to Roosevelt Sly Twia, Skinner Kadamanja, and Andrew Anson in Malawi, also Melons McLeod and Eamon Japhet Mfande in Zambia, and finally Kefa and Jones Gichana in Kenya. For you all, a delightful piece of music by a great group, and I always remember when they were at the height of their fame, this group, from 1977, they're called Odyssey, and I remember doing Top of the Pops, the famous British TV pop show here, and they were very, very big at the time, Odyssey, with this record that you're about to hear. And we met up at Top of the Pops, and they were just the sweetest, nicest people that you could have wished to meet. And I always thought, nah, they're too nice to be in show business. But not only did they act nicely with everybody, but they sang great as well. So here are Odyssey and Native New Yorker. New Yorker from Odyssey. A reminder, you're listening to the BBC Wild Service, and, well, there's three of us here today. There's Big Al, who is productificating, aren't you?
I'm trying to.
Yes, you are. You're trying against the odds.
I'm winning, slowly.
Very slowly.
Is this arm wrestle? You just keep beating me all the time.
No, I wouldn't beat you. And there's me. I'm twiddling knobs on this side, and then there's Keith next door, and he's twiddling the ultra knobs next door. See, they make you feel semi-powerful by putting you in a studio like this, don't they?
So you could turn you down?
Yeah, I can fiddle with all my little faders here and play it being a disc jockey.
But he's really in charge.
He's in charge, totally, Keith.
He's
got
the top man.
Ultimate control. He can just go, whoop, and I'm gone. No, I'm back again. It's all right. Right, OK, well, those are the three of us, and between us we have the entire BBC World Service at our mercy.
Scary, isn't it?
It is very scary. Mr. Apurba Kumar Pal from Rahmatpur in India, says, Dear Mr. Travis, hello and warm greetings to you and all your colleagues. I would like you to play the song Take This Heart by Richard Marx and dedicate it, please, to my sweet wife, Krishna, and to all my lovely friends around the world, including Pradeep, Andy, Nandita, Christine, Tina, Reggie, Angeline, Karen, Fiona, Kirsten, and Ruth. Warm regards from Apurva. Okay, we have Richard Marx inviting you to take this heart. His heart from Richard Marx, but then if you did, he'd fall down dead on the floor, wouldn't he? Him, yes. Right, this is the BBC, although you wouldn't know it employing idiots like me, would you? Tula Tillman from Carnegie in Australia has written in saying, Dear Mr. Travis, hang on, I've got this to turn this upside down. Many thanks for your cheerful and very entertaining programme. Could you please play Red Red Wine by UB40 as a dedication for my favourite cricket players, the West Indies team, who are in Australia this summer? These fabulous cricketers have made my summer holidays sheer bliss. Sincerely, Tula Tillman. Well, I don't know quite why you've chosen that particular record. Could it be that the West Indies team like to partake of the falling down water? Is that what you're trying to suggest, or is it just that they may like the record? All right, well, I'll let you make your own minds up. All I can do, I've been
scary and fun. My blues.
I think it's time to explain to the peoples of the world how UB40 got their name, don't you, Big Al?
Yeah.
I think so. Because it's an interesting story, because it's such an unusual name, UB40. I'm sure many of you out there know, but there still may be pockets of resistance around the world. People going, I don't want to know! I'm not interested! I don't want to know why they're called UB40! Well, I'm going to tell you. There is a form, which is basically an unemployment form, which you can get in this country if you're unemployed, because, of course, the boys, before they made it big, were basically unemployed. They had no money, they had nothing. And so they called themselves after the form. Originally, they were going to be called the Piece of White Paper Band, but they decided that UB40 was far, far better. This is Recognizable Gang. This, it means it's time for our pop pal. And our pop pal this week is Philip Danson from Libya. And Philip writes, my name is Philip Danson. I'm 34 years old, and I'm a citizen of Nigeria, but living in Libya. I left Nigeria because I like to travel. Ah, but how far did you go? Just sort of down the end of the street, maybe, or whatever. My other hobbies include jogging, weightlifting, tennis, reading, dancing, making friends, and, of course, writing letters. I want the whole world to hear this request because I would like to make friends from everywhere in the entire universe, and I will try to reply to all letters I receive. Good. Now, if you want to write to Philip, the address is Pop Pal Libya, a jolly good show, BBC World Service, Bush House, London. I'll give you that address again shortly. But first of all, let's have a listen to, well, the favourite record, basically, of Philip. But the other two, coming in a close second and third, are, at three, Tonight's the Night from Rod Stewart. At number two, Baby You Give Good Love from Whitney Houston. And at number one, well, strap on the white suits, gang. It's the Bee Gees.
Stay alive.
about the film Saturday Night Fever, that's Staying Alive from the Bee Gees, and, well, it brought a smile to my face and Big Al's as well. You may not know this, but apart from the film Saturday Night Fever, that some of you may have seen, there was another film which came out, which was just a completely idiotic film called Airplane, and they did what's known in the business as a Mickey take of the Bee Gees and that song and the dancing routine of John Travolta in the film. And it was so funny in this film, Airplane. If you ever get a chance to see a film called Airplane, not Aeroplane, but Airplane, you must see it because it's very, very funny. And unfortunately now, every time I hear that song, I can only see the funny version and not the serious one. Anyway, Philip is the person who is this week's Pop Pal, and if you'd like to write to him, it's the following address, Pop Pal Libya, A Jolly Good Show, BBC World Service, Bush House, London. And that, of course, is the address to write to should you wish to become a Pop Pal yourself. Give us your name, tell us where you're from, and do put in a few details of what you like and what you don't like, because that might help to decide the type of people that are going to write to you. And, of course, most importantly, your three favourite records. We will play the number one for you. Now, Chukwumela Aga from Port Harcourt in Nigeria says, Dear DLT, you might be wondering why I'm writing this letter. No? No, I just... Were you wondering why it's been this?
No,
letter?
Not at all. It just turned
I
up.
I just... No. It just, it was there, wasn't it? We were having a cup of tea. We weren't wondering.
We weren't expecting it.
No, it just it came out of the blue. Anyway, it says, I recently had a dream in which I wrote to you and you read my requests and played Santa Fe by Bon Jovi for me. So I'm wondering if you could make my dream come true. Please send my greetings to my brothers Ike, Chukwudi, Chinedu and Adira, my sister Isioma and my parents, and finally please say hello to my best friends Collins and Tunde. Dave, in my dream I also got a DLT shirt. Does this part come true as well? Yours truly, Chukwumela Aga. Well, let's see if we can get Santa Fe going first of all, shall we? You do realize that this is all a dream, don't you, Chuck? This is not happening at all. It's not happening at all. This is not happening at all. This is not happening at all. This is not happening at all.
They say that no man is an island. And good things come to those who wait. But the things I hear are there just to remind me.
Try to say it's too late.
Bon Jovi going raving bonkers with a number called Santa Fe. This is the BBC Wild Service. This is Travis Carr, and I hope that you're well. Now, can I just remind you about the little machine in the corner of the office? It's a fine machine. It's connected to the wall by a mains cable and also a telephone cable, which enables you to phone up and leave a magic message on it. Well, it's getting more and more like the X-Files in our office at the moment. That's a program, by the way, about the unusual. And the number, if you want to call, is London 171-379-4565. That's London 171-379-4565. Richmond Harding from Oakland in California has phoned the machine, and I would just like to warn people of a nervous disposition to be very careful as you listen to the message which is now coming up.
Dear DLT, this is Richmond Harding calling from Oakland, California. I am originally from Liberia, West Africa. I would like you to play a beautiful record for all of my good friends I left home in Liberia. I would like a special record.
Mm-hmm.
I'm afraid I do not know the name of the record, but it goes like this.
Gang, I have to warn you that Richmond actually starts to sing now, and I must go higher up the chain to ask my direct boss, Big Al, if we should continue with this tape, because he does sing, and you know how upsetting that can be for people. What do you think?
If I started singing,
yeah,
we'd have no listeners.
Right.
So I think Richmond can get away with it.
Do you reckon? Because he's a listener.
He's a listener, and he's not that bad.
Oh, actually...
Well, you've had a hit record.
That's true. Here comes Richmond singing. This is the song he doesn't know the name of.
Nothing compares... Nothing compares to you. Thank you very much. Love your show. Bye now.
Richmond, thank you. I'm sorry. We shouldn't laugh, really, because after all, your voice is better than Sinead O'Connor's. O'Connor, nothing compares to you. And thank you very much indeed to Richmond Harding for, braving the airwaves by actually singing the song for us. And anybody else who wants to do what Richmond did, or at least get the request in rather than sing, the number to call is London 171-379-4565. Now, Rashid Issa from Koforidua in Ghana says, "Dear Dave, would you be kind enough to play something by Mariah Carey for my lovely parents in the USA, my friend Bob Abdul and my sweetheart Michelle? I want them to know that I love them a lot and wish them all the best for 1997. Your faithful listener, Rashid Issa." Thank you, Rashid, for taking the trouble to write into us. It's always nice to hear from people, faithful listeners or otherwise. Yes, don't have to be totally faithful. You can go away because we know you'll always come back again. That's the important thing. Here is one of Mariah Carey's records, in which if you have any very expensive glassware, maybe near the fireplace or something, or within earshot of the radio, be very careful, because she hits some high notes that are enough to break glass anywhere. Actually, Big Al's taken his glasses off and put them in his pocket. He's taking no chances. Enjoyed that, and indeed the rest of the music and requests that we've had on today's program, because unfortunately it's time for us to go now. Can I remind you, if you'd like to drop us a line for a request, it's DLT, a Jolly Good Show, BBC World Service, Bush House, London, or you can call on the answer machine on London 171 379 4565. Once again, the address is DLT, A Jolly Good Show, BBC World Service, Bush House, London. It's time to go. We thank you, the Three Stooges here. We thank you very much indeed for listening into the program. We hope that we can do it again real soon. In the meantime, till next time, you stay healthy. See you soon. Bye-bye.